Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Welcome back to the second half of our Bedford Proms in the Park. Music from, well, it depends on which side of the fence you sit. For half of the audience, that's the last section of half of the overture by Rossini to his final opera. The other half of the audience, of course, is music to the lower range. You pay him money and you take your choice. We're going to stick with opera, actually, for another great set piece from the world of opera, this time from Verdi and his wonderful masterpiece, Aida. Joining the London Gala Orchestra to sing in the Grand March of Ireland. Please put your hands together once again for the Bedford Choral Society.
Thank you.
wonderful dramatic music from Verdi there with the grand triumphal march from Aida, complete with the fanfare trumpets. One small step really from opera, I guess, to the world of musical. Lerner and Lowe's finest contains this great song, singing I Could Have Danced All Night. Please welcome back the wonderful voice of Victoria Joyce.
We've all been cooped up for so long. I'd just like to say, for us, it's so exciting to be able to get out here again and make live music. And a huge, huge thanks. Please join me in your appreciation for the London Gala Orchestra. Absolutely amazing. Thank you. It's you. I've got to admit, I am a Bedford virgin. Yeah, I have never been to Bedford, so I've had a fantastic time so far. If I go somewhere new, I always like to look up a little bit of information about it. So I put in top three interesting facts about Bedford. Well, I actually put in top 10 interesting facts about Bedford and found three. Three of my favourite. John Bunyan, I did not know this, wrote The Pilgrim's Progress. But maybe didn't make that much progress because he was stuck in the county prison. So maybe that was his inspiration. Bedford hosts the longest village in the country. 6 mile round trip to borrow a cup of sugar off your neighbour. 3 miles long, apparently, Arlesley. And my absolute favourite, all the sand, well, a large majority of the sand in Saudi Arabia comes from Leighton Buzzard, which I just thought was brilliant. There you go. Anyway, enjoy the rest of the night. I could not.
going to ask Victoria to stay on stage as we do our next duet in a wonderful song that was originally recorded by Sarah Brightman and Andrea Bocelli, singing Time to Say Goodbye. In addition to Victoria Joyce, welcome back, Mr. Wynne, Evan.
I've also been doing a little bit of what Victoria did. I've been looking up the most interesting thing about Bedford on the internet. You'll be pleased to know, girls, I am not a Bedford virgin. The most interesting thing I could find about Bedford on the internet is that it's 43 minutes from London on the train. Like it's the first time I've heard it. Really funny, mate. Did you think of that all by yourself? Fantastic. Well done. Just remember, I'm the one with a mic and you're never going to win. Oh, I never got out of hand there. Anyway, never mind. Wait, I was like that after my first glass of wine. I was totally out of hand. Anyway. Believe it or not, obviously Gokin Pay has changed my life beyond any kind of recognition. For many years, I know you're not going to believe this, but I was voted the most hated man in Britain. So much so that my friend said to me once, he said, have you seen the Facebook hate site to you? I hate Gwyn Evans, the Gokin Pay man. I said, no, I haven't seen it. True story. I looked at it, there was quite a lot of members. So what I thought I'd do is look at somebody that I didn't like and see how many people hated them. I looked up Nick Griffin, the leader of the British National Party. 75,000 people hate Nick Griffin on Facebook. 2.75 million hate me. It's all right, because people say to me, does it make you sad? And I say, yes, I cry every night in the back of my Porsche looking at my Rolex. I'm going to sing a song now. I'd like to take this opportunity to wish you all a very happy Christmas. No, because I know how difficult it is to find those little stocking fillers and my CD. You're better off buying my CD in sets of six, because it's a terrible CD, but it makes a wonderful poster. And this is the title track of my first CD that amazingly went to number one in the classical charts, and it's called With a Song in My Heart. With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. Just a song from the stars, and in tune is a hymn to your grace. When the music swells, I'm touching your hand. It tells me you're standing. Like the sound of your voice. But it waters to me when I help but enjoy that a song such as ours need to be. I'm always yours. I would live like a to sing. You don't sound too sure. Are you ready to sing?
Yeah.
Right. I have sang this at Bedford before. In fact, I've sung it all over the world, and you may have recently seen it in one of the Dope and Pear adverts, not that song. Don't sing it again. Great. Another £3. So, I want you to be my instant chorus. Will you be my instant chorus? Okay, we're going to have a little rehearsal, and it goes something like this. La 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 la. And then you stop. Now, campervanning has become very popular during lockdown, and I'm thrilled to say that they've now made a campervan named after this song. The Nissan Dormer. It is the song from the opera La World Cup 1990. It is called Nissan Dormer.
Make your mama glad to have had such a lad. Tell your sweetheart
Times. We've got some very, very special guests for you to meet now. Please welcome back to the stage the wonderful Sam Roberts.
Well, I'm here to announce something very special. The tickets for the Proms next year. We have a part B to the proceedings. 25 years we've been doing this. And we want to get you guys there next year. And that's the reason why you know now that from tomorrow, tickets will be available to you as you were here tonight for a special price of £14 per person. And we'd like to have you all here. No one else knows about that, just you here tonight. £14 per person from tomorrow. We'd love to have you here with us. And our very special guest this evening is not me. Overnight, our next guest became an integral part of the world's greatest philanthropic lightning strike that saw their late father and grandfather, Captain Sir Tom Moore, raise £38.9 million in 3.5 weeks. They continue to raise further funds and awareness in his honour at the Captain Tom Foundation, and that family is very much here at the heart of Bedford and Bedfordshire. It is with great pleasure that I introduce to you Bedford Park, Hannah and Benji Ingram Moore!
What I can say to you is that as a family, we had absolutely no idea when we challenged my father at 99 years of age to walk 100 laps of our garden, the panda lap, to raise money for our frontline workers. Little could we have known that just 3.5 weeks later, that amount would be £38.9 million. And we couldn't have done it without you. People from 163 countries donated. That means only 30 countries in the world did not. The reach was simply extraordinary. And we, and he felt that every time he spoke, if just one word he spoke of hope gave someone just a little bit more to live for in this terrible time, then he would keep talking, giving hope to the world. It was as we hit £12 million in that second week that we realised we needed to lock away this incredible legacy, this powerful gift of hope that he'd given us by creating the Captain Tom Foundation. And with the foundation, we are determined to ensure that his lasting legacy of hope lives on, and we couldn't do it without you. I would like to, before I tell you some really exciting news, just pass over to Benji so he can perhaps tell you from the perspective of a different generation what it felt like to walk side by side with my father as he touched the world.
I've been sat backstage for the last 15 minutes trying to decide what I'm going to say, but as I come out on stage now, it becomes evidently obvious. The amount of families that I see up here tonight after a year of being locked away from all different generations, it only reminds me of the last 13 years I had with my grandfather. I can be completely honest, it was the best thing that ever happened to me. I just want to say to all the kids out there, please treasure your parents, please treasure your grandparents, because they are absolutely incredible, and you may not realise it now, but please don't treat them right, because they are amazing. Knowing my grandfather was the biggest pleasure. I mean, him being up north has taught me a few things, but imagine a better person to have lived my last 13 years with. And just, I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you all so much for following us on this journey over the last year. You are absolutely incredible, and we've had a massive pleasure meeting all of you, so thank you so much.
thank you all again. And you'll see that the Bedford Proms will be on the 31st of July of next year. I think you all know that. And it is a real pleasure and a delight of mine to tell you that the promoter of Bedford Park Concerts, Mark Harrison, is giving away 8,000 tickets to NHS workers, those amazing NHS workers, for £1. Thank you all once again for ensuring my father's lasting legacy of hope lives on. We couldn't do it without you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Hannah, thank you so much. Hannah, and I've programmed your mobile phone, so all you have to do is press hit, and you can start the fireworks a little later. But I've got a bit of an update. So 8,000 tickets will be given away to next year's Bedford Park Proms to NHS workers. It was going to be for £1, and it will still cost £1, but I've spoken with Mark Harrison this evening, the promoter, and he has told me that he will donate each and every pound back to the NHS. So it is going to be a totally free concert if you are an NHS worker. So 8,000 tickets. Who is going to join me next year on this day? It's going to be the biggest party in town. Also, we have renamed it. If this year is the 25th anniversary, and because we missed out on last year, we've decided next year's Bedford Park Proms will be called the 25th anniversary part 2. I can't wait to see you all there. Tickets are available from tomorrow, but now back to this wonderful orchestra and Stephen Bell.
Thank you, Wynne, very much indeed. Lot of fabulous news. We've got a couple of pieces in tribute to Captain Sir Tom in just a moment with Colonel Bogey and the wonderful Gambusters March. But first, given our chance to have our laser team strut their stuff through a wonderful piece of Cacciatura, this is the Sabre Dance.